A question for Marvin, really, which is partly what your plans are to defend local authority education and oppose the Academy's plan, but specifically, why did you bring a Conservative councillor onto your cabinet and put them in charge of the education thing? I was quite a concerning sign, really, considering what the Tories are doing to education nationally, that you would kind of put a fox in charge of the hen house in that way. And, you know, I wonder what the thinking is behind that and how we're able to defend local authority education when we're bringing in some of the architects of academy plans into the around the top table and into the decision-making process.
Tom. So let's look at the way, you know, there's a context to the cabinet. First of all, throughout, we committed to a cross-party cabinet, we committed to a gender-balanced cabinet, and we committed to making sure that, that we stay true to that. We have a number of portfolios in the cabinet, so if we look at the way the city actually works, no single portfolio works independently of any other portfolio. So we have collective accountability. So while Claire Hiscott is in charge of, is taking charge of skills and education, ultimately I remain the mayor. And we have a cabinet, which is obviously clearly overwhelmingly Labour, to make sure that the cabinet lead, who will have a performance framework around her, making sure she hits the targets, is actually working in line with the agenda we've put out. And the other day, as we sat at the table and as we looked each other in the eyes, we were brokering. I said, I'm not going to be a liar. It's one thing I won't do. If I commit to a cross-party cabinet, I'll deliver a cross-party cabinet as long as people agree with the priorities we have. And this was a discussion. The discussion was, now that Labour has a majority of councillors as well, which we expected, don't you have every right to go back on what you said and have just a Labour cabinet? And I said, well, then we'll be liars. And the price you pay for being a liar is greater than the price you pay for staying true and taking the hits you'll take from having a cross-party cabinet. I actually think that's important. But she will not be making decisions alone. We're making decisions with me and the cabinet. We're also going to have a lead for the Labour Party that will be on education and skills, and will be our key point of scrutiny over what goes on. And besides that, I can say that as we sat across the table and looked each other in the eye, she said her words were to me was, basically, I'm going to deliver on your agenda. As we met a bunch of head teachers yesterday, including a teacher of my child's own primary school, she was at pains to point out the difference that she had between her and central government policy as well. So things ain't going to be perfect, but this is the real world. It's not a world where you can stand on a touchline with your beautiful purity, saying everything you want and not have to give something. This is one where you have to give something to get something. And actually, and what we'll do is we'll work it as we go along. But my commitment is to make sure that we get the commitments in our manifesto delivered, and I'll expect all my cabinet leads to do that. But we've got to give something.
Absolutely.